In this video, we're going to discuss a complex related rates problem dealing with angles and trigonometry. So, two buildings of height 20 feet and 40 feet are 60 feet apart. Suppose that the intensity of light at a point between the buildings is proportional to the angle phi in the figure. If a person is moving from right to left at 4 feet per second, at what rate is phi changing when the person is exactly halfway between the two buildings? So, first, note that it doesn't look exactly like you can solve it right off the bat. You have to think of ways to express this phi angle. And for this reason, I would advise you to take a look at the phi angles that are adjacent to this phi angle that together will make a sum of 180 degrees, right? Because this is the ground level. So all of these three angles that are adjacent to one another will be equal to 180 degrees when summed up. Okay, so we'll make this angle adjacent to the left, phi 1, no, sorry, let me just do it a little better. So we're going to make it phi 1, and this we're going to make phi 2. Okay, so these are going to be the adjacent angles. So note now that we can express this phi angle, which is the angle of interest here. So we're going to say phi is equal to 180 minus the sum of phi 1 and phi 2. Okay? So now, notice that you have to find d phi dt, right? Because it's asking you what rate is phi changing at what rate. So you obviously have to find the rate of change of this phi angle, right? So we're going to differentiate now both sides. Well, let's write it out in a more simplified form. Minus phi 1 minus phi 2. So now the d phi dt with respect to time, the rate of change of this angle of interest, is going to be differentiating both sides, right? So 180 will turn to 0. So you will have minus d phi 1 divided by the dt minus d phi 2 divided by the d of t. Okay? So now it remains to find these respective rates of changes for each of these adjacent angles, phi 1 and phi 2, in order to find the resulting rate of change for the phi, for the main angle of interest in the middle. Okay? So now we're going to have to use the given information. Let's work with the left right triangle first. Why is it a right triangle? Because it's a building, right? It must be vertical relative to the, it must be perpendicular relative to the ground. Okay, so I can mark it as a 90 degree angle here and a 90 degree angle there. Okay? So let's work with phi 1 first, the left triangle here. So we know that dx dt, well, let's break the 60, the distance between the two buildings, the 60 into two parts. The base for the left triangle and the remaining part of the base for the right triangle. Okay? So this base of this triangle, we can label it as x. Okay? And this base of this triangle, we can label it as 60 minus x. Okay? So now, it says that the person will walk from right to left, right? So he's going to walk this way, from right to left. And since we chose the x as the base, the x will decrease because the person will move from right to left, right? So if x is decreasing, that means that the rate at which the person is walking should be negative. Okay, so we're going to label it as, so dx dt, and notice that it corresponds to dx dt because we're talking about the rate of change of the horizontal, right? So dx dt will be negative 4 because x will decrease as the person will move from right to left, right? The distance, the base of this triangle will decrease. So dx dt is equal to negative 4. Now, we can use trigonometry to express, in order to express phi 1, right? So we're going to say tangent of phi 1 is equal to 20 divided by x. And the same thing we're going to do for the second triangle. We're going to say tangent of phi 2 is equal to 40 divided by 60 minus x, right? I'm just using the opposite over adjacent property of tangent here, okay? So 60 minus x, okay? So now I'm going to differentiate both sides. And why? Because remember, in order to find the d phi dt, we must find individual respective rates of changes for each of these adjacent angles, right? So I need to find d phi 1 divided by dt. And so for this one as well, d phi 2 divided by the dt. So for this reason, I'm going to differentiate both sides using implicit differentiation technique. So I'm going to have secant squared phi 1 multiplied by d phi 1 divided by the dt. And notice now I have this d phi 1 divided by dt, which is what we need in the formula, right? And the second, the right side of this equation will turn to, as you should know, if we take, we don't even have to use the product rule. I mean, sorry, the quotient rule, because we can treat 20 as a constant and deal with 1 over x. And you know the derivative of 1 over x is negative 1 over x squared. Okay, this is what you should memorize. Okay, so basically what we're going to have is minus 20 over x squared. And remember that you still have to differentiate the x, so it's going to be dx dt, right? Now using the second side here, I'm just gonna separate this for a little bit, and I'm gonna do the same thing. So I'm gonna say secant squared of phi 2 multiplied by the d phi 2 divided by the dt is equal to, and here we're gonna use the quotient rule. We know that when we take the derivative of 40 is going to be 0, and then we have to subtract, well, I'm just going to write it out here, 0 times 60 minus x minus 40, and then the derivative of 60 minus x is negative 1, right, divided by squaring the 60 minus x, 60 minus x squared, okay? So that so I'm just going to rewrite it here. Secant squared phi 2 times d phi 2 dt is equal to 40 over 60 minus x. Sorry, it's a little bit messed up here. So 60 minus x squared. So I'm just going to work simultaneously. I'm solving both sides. So let me finish this side. So basically, d phi 2 divided by the dt will be equal to 40 divided by 60 minus x squared multiplied by cosine squared phi 2. And why cosine squared? Because 1 divided by secant squared is cosine squared, okay? So let's do the same thing on the left side. So I'm going to solve for d phi 1. So d phi 1 divided by the dt is equal to negative 20 over x squared multiplied by cosine squared phi 1, okay? So now you might say, well, what are you going to do with this now? You have an x there. Well, remember that the x is given, actually, right? Because it says, look, at what rate is phi changing when the person exactly halfway? So that's a keyword right there. And halfway means the midpoint of this distance between the buildings. So the midpoint is 30, right? So when x is equal to 30, right? So we can substitute this in. And we're going to get negative 20 over 30 squared, right? X is 30, 30 squared is going to be 900 cosine squared phi 1. And here we're going to have 40 divided by, oh, sorry, did I forget dx dt here? Oops, I think I forgot it here. Dx dt, right. Sorry about that. Dx dt must exist there. Okay, and remember dx dt is negative 4, so we're going to substitute that. So that's going to be the same thing, right? 30 squared is 900 times cosine squared phi 2 times, let's substitute dx dt now, minus 4. And here we're going to have also times minus 4. And that's going to give us, let's see, so 80 divided by 900, that's 8 divided by 90, that's 4 divided by 45, right? 445 cosine squared phi 1. And this is going to give us 160, negative 160 divided by 900, that's negative 16 over 90, that's negative 8 over 45, negative 8 over 45 cosine squared phi 2. And notice that this makes sense because we're pretty much having a negative rate of change for the phi 2, right? It makes sense because as the person moves from right to left, this angle phi 2 will decrease, right? Because the angle will become more and more acute, okay? And this angle phi 1 will increase, and that makes sense with the positive coefficient here, 445 cosine squared phi 1. Okay, so now it remains to find the phi 1 and phi 2 when x is equal to 30, right? When the person approaches the halfway point. So now let's see. So when x is equal to 30, we can say phi 1 is equal to arctangent of 20 divided by 30, right? Because we need to find what the phi 1 angle is when the tangent of this angle is equal to 20 divided by 30, right? So that's going to equal to, let's use the calculator and see. So basically 2 over thirds, the tangent of negative 1 is in degrees 33.6900. So now we need to find the cosine squared of that, right? So I'm just going to add the cosine here. Well, whatever that's going to be, right? I'm not going to solve it, but I'm going to say cosine squared of, sorry, phi 1 is going to be basically cosine squared of this guy, tangent of negative 1 over of 20 over 30, or 2 over 3 is the same thing, right? So let's see. So tangent, the arctan of 2 over 3 is 33.6900 6753 degrees. Taking the cosine of that and then squaring it gives me 0.69230 692. And notice that it doesn't matter whether you're in degree or radian mode. The reason being is that we're basically finding the value of the cosine, right? So even degrees or radians, it doesn't change the answer. Okay, so now let's use the so basically the answer is this, right? The answer is 4 over 45 multiplied by 0.69230 7692. Okay, and now let's calculate this cosine squared of phi 2, right? So we're going to use the same thing. I'm just going to do it quicker here. I want you to try to understand what I'm doing. I'm not going to start from the very beginning, but cosine squared of phi 2, I'm going to use the same technique, is cosine squared of the arctangent of what? Of 40 divided by 30, right? Because x is 30 here as well. 60 minus 30 is 30 also, right? It's halfway. So 4 over 3, I'm just going to write 40 over 30 in order not to confuse you, but it's basically 4 over 3. And let's see what the calculator gives me. So 4 over 3 taking arctangent gives me 53.1301023 5 degrees, and taking the cosine of that and then squaring it gives me 0.36. Okay, excellent. Much better, a much better number than this long number, right? So the answer here is going to be -8 over 45 multiplied by 0.36. So now it's a very long problem, and we actually solved it now, right? Because we have the missing pieces now in order to find the d phi dt, right? Because we just found d phi 1 over dt and d phi 2 divided by the dt, right? So now basically we're going to have d phi divided by the dt is equal to negative 4.45 multiplied by 0.692307692, and then minus 845 gives you a plus 845, right? The net plus 845 multiplied by 0.36. Let's see what that gives us. I'm just going to write a long number to see what we have. So 0.692307692 multiplied by 4 divided by 45, negate that, and then plus 8 times 0.36 divided by 45. That gives me 0.002461538. And what is this, what are the units going to be? The units are going to be radians per second, right? Because we were dealing with radians. And obviously, this is a very small number, so it makes sense that it's going to be radians per second. If you were to convert this to degrees, you would just multiply this result by 180 and divide it by pi. And then that would give you degrees. If you want, I can show you what it is. It's going to be times 180 divided by pi. So that's about 0.141 degrees or something like that per second. Okay, anyway, I hope this tutorial was useful. It's a very complicated problem, but if you know how to break it down, you will be able to solve it. If you don't understand, just go back in the video again where I discuss all my steps in detail. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video.